cleaning the filter on an E Series, IVT, or a Worcester Bosch Greenstore E Series. First thing you need is a spanner, and you're going to want a Torx screwdriver, a T25. You're going to want to take two Torx screws out the top at the front of the unit. They look like this. Once you've done that, ours is just hooked on. You're then going to take the front cover off. It's going to pull forward and up, and then you can take it off. There will be a wire attached to the front panel, so don't go too far with it. Place it just next to the heat pump. Then inside, we're going to have our return filter. You want to turn the unit off by pressing the on-off button on the front display. So on our one, it would be here. On an IVT, it would be above the display. Then inside, we want to turn the handle to 90 degrees, so pull it down so it's the opposite way. And then you're going to want to take this cap off. This is where you'll need your spanner. So we're going to go onto the cap, and it shouldn't be very tight, so you're going to give it a little turn like that, and then you should be able to undo it. You'll want a towel just below this. Ours hasn't got any water in for demonstration, but you'll lose about an egg cup full of water. You're going to take this cap off, and then inside is the filter, so just put your finger in and take it out. Obviously ours is nice and clean, it's got no water in it. Give that a clean out under the tap, and then you're going to want to put it back in. There's two little locating tabs on the filter. These will line up with little notches inside on the filter in there. So we've got one on the side and there's one on the top. So we're going to put it back in and it will line up, and these notches will then push into place like that. If they're not lined up, you won't be able to push it in. Once you've done that, put the cap back on. And then with the spanner, just tighten it up a little bit. It doesn't have to be excessively tight. So just a tiny little nip like that. Put the valve back up. If you've got a slight drip, just try giving it a little tighten again. Don't go too tight, otherwise it might leak a bit more. Then turn the unit on and we're all done.